we are back with video number two of live and rarities CDs. I couldn't help it, but I saw some other stuff from these folks and ordered again. So I thought I'd do another unboxing for people and show you what I got this time. If you're a music junkie like me, a collecting junkie like me, you'll get it. And last time they sent me at the bottom of the box this little slip that invites me to their website, which is secret and private, and so they give me a code to get in there. And my goodness, there is a lot of stuff. All right, I already know what's in this box, just like last time, but you do not, so let's get to it and show you what's... Oh, and as far as an update from the last video for the sound, I thought there were some issues with skipping, which happens with CDR sometimes, but it turns out it was my player. I tried it in two other players, and they sounded fantastic, so I bought a new CD player because mine was just a little portable one. So, all right, so the first one is, well, the first one I'm going to do now is Rockpile Volume 2. That ain't happened before. And there's the picture on the front and the picture on the back. And it's the same setup as in the other video. All of these are, they have four or five CDs and a little insert. There's the back pictures, the front and back pictures of the insert there, and then what's on the CDs is right there. So if you want to really see it, you can freeze it for a moment and you can see all the songs that are on this and all the shows that are on this. Some of these might be rehearsals and outtakes and demos and unreleased songs, but most of these I think are live. Alrighty, and here is another one from Rockpile Volume 1. If you saw my other video, you know how these things go. Oh, the cases are pretty fragile. I'll remind people if they want to get any of this stuff from these folks. I'll show you how to open them. Rockpile, that ain't happened before. Volume 1, there's the front and the back. If you want to, well, the CDs kind of sometimes come out, but you kind of got to do that, and then to close it, you can't just do that, it'll kind of get stuck, so you got to finesse it with the other one, bring it back, and put them together, and then close it. And here is, well, that's pretty, going to be tough to read. There's the insert, and... Oh, blocking somebody's head there. Here's the insert, and there's the rest of the insert and what's on there. And it's a pretty crazy print for this one. Might be hard to read, but that's all the shows and all the discs, everything on this disc. Oh, and there's an update on the sound also from the last shipment, since I've listened to a lot of it now. An update on the sound is that I was really impressed. I mean, there was a couple discs here and there that were, you know, not the greatest quality, but for the most part, everything was really, really, really good quality. Radio broadcast, but good sounding radio broadcast, or soundboard. Again, good sounding soundboards. All right, now this one is a 3-volume set here, and I was so thrilled to see so much on him there that I bought all 3, and I don't think there's a lot of overlap for me in these sets, because again, they list everything that's on there. Chuck Berry, look at that, volume 1, and there's the back. Now it looks like a bunch of these are like those Dave Edmonds ones that I showed you last time, where the pictures are go in a different direction than the CD case. There's the front and the back of the insert, and now here is everything on the inside. I'm hoping none of this is repeated in the Bear Family set, 16 CD Bear Family set, which I have also, and I it didn't look like anything was repeated, but I didn't check that really closely. I also have all the chess sets, the three, four CD chess sets, and I don't think there's a lot of repeat. They'll probably repeat that 72 show from the BBC somewhere on here, and that's okay. All right, that is the first set of the Chuck Berry. And now set number two of the Chuck Berry. Oh, and once again, I made an offer and they gave me a great deal. They sent me seven sets for $150, which means about 21 and some change for each set. Last time it was 200 for nine sets, and that was 22 something. So they've been real, and they asked for free shipping, and they gave me free shipping. They've been really good about all that, about making the deal. They you know, and again, these probably cost $5 to make if they make it. They said they don't make them, but they know the people who do, whatever that means. So maybe they get them for $10 or maybe even less, who knows. And there's what's on the Chuck Berry disc, and there's our boy Keith, of course, the director of that film. Not the director of the film, but the director of the show in that film, Hail, Hail, Rock and Roll, about Chuck Berry. That was a great movie, great documentary, great live show that Keith was the music coordinator on. Alrighty. And now the last Chuck Berry. And here we go. Volume 3, Chuck Berry. There's the front. There's the back. And boy, every single one of these just three has kind of fallen out there. And there is the pictures on the front and back of the insert there. There are the pictures. And then here are the shows or set lists or songs that are on each disc of this last Chuck Berry set. So I've been real impressed with this stuff, you know. Again, the discs are, you know, they're burns, and but they're nice, you know, nicely done with a picture on the front, and for what you get for the money, it's pretty good. And again, the sound on everything I've had has been very, very good. Or certainly if I've already had a copy of that show or one of the shows, it's been, you know, at least as good as the other copy or better. You know, these things get upgrades all the time. I showed you last time of the Creedence Earthquakes and Lightning Volume 1. Here's Creedence Earthquakes and Lightning Volume 2. Either I didn't see it last time, or I didn't think, or I didn't really check how much was on there that I had already very thoroughly. I do that every time to make sure I'm not duplicating more than a disc or maybe two if it's something real special. So there's the outside of the insert. Picture one, picture two. And here are all the shows there. Not easy to find Creedence stuff, so now I've got two of these sets. I'm pretty happy about that. Excited to listen to them. All right, I think that's it. There's one more. One more, and we're done. And this one's a real goofy one. Not goofy, but I just was excited and surprised to see this. They have a lot of interesting stuff. Hundreds and hundreds of choices. But this, I don't know how to say his name, Jorma Kaukonen from Hot Tuna. And I'm hoping that this is mostly acoustic stuff. It looks like they're listing on the back some of the discs, maybe all of them actually, because I think this is only three discs. So I'm really hoping that this, sorry about the glare there, I'm really hoping that this is, it doesn't help, does it? I'll take the insert out. I'm really hoping that this is, oh there we go, acoustic shows of his, because I love his acoustic CDs. They had an electric Hot Tuna set. I don't know how many volumes, but they had at least one, four or five CD one. They got a bunch of Dire Straits and Kinks and Faces and Fleetwood Mac and Stevie Nicks and all kinds of other bands. Oh my goodness, now this looks hard to read. So, but there it is. And before I close up shop and go, I will throw on, why don't we throw on disc one of Jorma? Be right back. There's a little of Chuck Berry and the Jorma Kaukonen. They both sound pretty good. So there you have it. There's a little bit of the sound of them, three of them. The Creedence I listened, I only sampled the first two discs, and they sounded okay, not great. The Chuck Berry sounded like it was demos, probably. I hope it's not Bear Family stuff. But the Rockpile sounds good. The Jorma sounded good. And the other stuff, the Dave Edmonds that I've heard so far, the first two volumes sounded fantastic. Almost all the discs were really great. There was a couple that were audience, but they were still good. And the John Fogerty was really good. And the Mudcrutch was very good. It was a good audience. I didn't listen to the second one yet. Anyway, that's it. Thanks for watching, and have a great day. Bye. Please leave a like or a comment. I'd love to hear what anybody thinks. Thanks.